Hello guys, thanks for watching my video. Today I'm also going to be showing you how to make a peplum blouse with collar and zip at the front. I'll show you what we need for this tutorial. So we're making a blouse. Just hold on 1 second. We are going to be needing the fabric, the scissors, measurement tape, and the pieces measurement, chalk, and the ruler. So first, you need to have 2 pieces of fabric. One is for the back, one is for the front. And this fabric is the person's half length. Half length is the shoulder to the waist. That's the half length. On the back one, we are not going to be putting zip allowance. On the front one, we are going to be adding zip allowance to the front one because the zip is going to be at the front and it's going to be having a collar. So let's start. So as you can see, I have laid the fabric. The fabric is folded into two. Okay, and I've laid the fabric. One is 2 inches longer. Can you see my finger? One of them is 2 inches longer. So first thing we are going to do is we need to take the shoulder measurement of the person. Shoulder measurement. The shoulder measurement is 15. Okay, you mark 15 down. Okay. The person armhole divided into 2 is 9. Okay, you mark 9 here. You take your ruler and you just draw a straight line. Okay. And from that 9 as well, you can draw another straight line to that side. Okay, so now we are working with the back on top. The bottom one is the front. So at the back, we just measure across the wideness of the neck. We are going to use 3.5 inches. Or you can use 3 inches, but it's a female's top. So the neck, she doesn't want the neck to be too tight. So I'm going to use 3 inches. And the depth, I'm going to use 1.5 inch. So don't forget our shoulder is not straight. So I'm going to drop 1.5 inches down. I'm going to mark 1 inch down. So I drop 1 inch down. Okay, so that will be our shoulder. From that 1 inch, you just draw a straight line, slanted line. See that? That's how our shoulder looks like. So from this point, you can either use your curve ruler or you can freehand it and just draw a curve for the neck, the back neck. For the front neck, we are going to go down by 3 inches, or you can come down a bit more by 3.5 inches, but we are going to go down by 3 inches. And then you can just connect it as well. Don't forget, this here is the front, so when you want to cut the back, cut the 1.5. Don't cut the front one, it will be too low. Okay, so now we are going to take all our other measurements. Bust measurement, waist measurement, under bust measurement, shoulder to under bust, shoulder to waist. So from the very top, I'm going to just measure shoulder to waist, which is Shoulder to waist is 19. 19 plus 1 inch. The 1 inch is to sew half an inch here and to sew half an inch at the bottom. And just roll it, draw a straight line across. Shoulder to our under bust, which is 16. So just from the very top here, measure shoulder to under bust. Draw a straight line across. Okay, so now we are going to take our bust measurement, which is a bust divided by 4, is 11. So I'm going to mark. But first, before I do that, just to get a bust point, which is where a bust point is. A bust point is 12. So I'm going to mark 12 down here. That's just so I know where a bust starts from. Just draw a straight line to the other side. So I'm going to mark 11 here. Then on the bust measurement, divided by four. On the bust measurement divided by 4 is 10.75. So I just round it to 11, to the nearest figure. I'm just going to calculate that just to make sure I'm right. Quick calculation. Okay, on the bust measurement is 10 actually. So it's 10. Less than. Our waist measurement is also 10. So now I'm going to be adding 2 inches sewing allowance. 2 inches to the bust, 2 inches. Or you could put 1.5 inches to the under bust. 2 inches to the waist measurement. Or rather still, we can put we are going to put 3 inches to the waist. Reason is because we are going to be having a dart. So 1 inch is for the dart. So we put 3 inches to the waist measurement. And you just take your ruler and connect all the markings with your ruler. Take your curve ruler and just draw a curve, because the human body has a curve, it doesn't, it's not point. So that's it. So now to get the hem hole, you measure the remaining of the hem hole length, which is 8 divided by 2, that's 4. So from here you can either freehand it. I'll take a curved ruler. And just connect it like that. See? And that's it. So what I'll do now is cut it out. And then once I cut it out, I'm going to cut the peplum, because it's a peplum blouse with collar. Thank you. black neck first. Then we'll cut the front one. So this is the back, because you got no zip. That's the back. That's the front. I'm just going to cut it open for the zip allowance. Okay, so that's all. Okay guys, I'm going to show you how to cut the peplum, how I cut my peplum. So what I do first of all, I take a fabric, I fold it into two, then I fold it into two again, making it into four. So in total, I fold it into four. So when I fold it into four, I measure from the tip here to here, seven. That's the waist measurement plus the zip allowance, everything I had. And then I measure seven. So just could be six or five. If you are a very small person, I think you should just use, if you want the flare, the peplum to really flare properly, you know. So you can either use five or you can use six or four if you're very small. So I'm going to use seven. That's going to be the opening. So I'll mark seven all the way around. At the bottom here, I'm going to mark the length of the peplum plus 1 inch sewing allowance. So the length of the peplum is 7 plus 1 inch sewing allowance, make it 8. So I'm just going to first of all measure the 7 all the way around first. 7 all the way around. So what you do, you just freehand it and you draw a circle. So now you are going to measure 8 in the form of a circle shape. You measure 8. So 8 there. Bring your tape around. 8. Once you cut it out, you are going to take this to cut your lining as well. So this is for the front and back peplum plus zip allowance. So all you do, you cut one side open. Just cut one section open. Let me open it up so you see. Can you see? Okay. That's your peplum. So this is going to go all the way round to the front of the blouse. You know the front has a zip, so the zip allowance is here. So I'm going to put it all the way around, like so, round. And then I'll take this and cut the lining as well. So I'm going to cut the sleeve. Not to make the video to be too long, I'm going to use my quick method of how to cut a sleeve. Quick method. So my quick method is I measure 1 inch as a guideline. Take my ruler and just draw a line across. Okay. I'm sewing a 3/4 sleeve. So I measure the sleeve length 16. Plus I need 1.5 inches or 1 inch to hem it, or to sew the hem, to turn it. So I measure 17.5, and then you need 0.5 inches to sew it on top as well. So that'll be 18. So I'm marking 18. I mark 18 all the way, just to get a straight line. I take my ruler and just draw a straight line. Okay, so the person's bicep is 16. 16 divided by 2 is 8, plus 1 inch sewing allowance. So it's here. Now, just under our elbow, which is here, from there to there, is 14. So 14 divided by 2 is 7. Plus 1 inch or 0.5 inch sewing allowance. I'll put 0.5 inch. 7.5. Okay, that's 7.5. 7.5. That's our biceps. So from the top here, because I'm doing a quick sleeve, I don't want the video to be too extremely long. So from the top here, what I do is I measure 3 inches. If you are a bust 40, 3 inches is okay, or 3.5 inches. If you are a bust 45, 3.5 inches. If you are a bust 50 something, then you need to use 4. So what I do is I just measure 3 inches. 3 inches here. From that point, I just freehand it from here. This is the edge of the sleeve. You don't cut this part open. So from that edge, I just freehand it to this point. So this is what I do. See? Freehand it to that point. You can also measure it just to make sure that the armhole is not too, open, so that when you want to sew it on the blouse, the armhole is not too much. So from here, I take my hip curve ruler, which is also good for sleeves. I take my hip curve ruler and then mark it out. Do you see that? So that's my sleeve, quick sleeve. My quick method of how to cut a sleeve. Then you cut it out and that's it, done. That's my sleeve. That's the quick way of cutting a sleeve. So that's it, guys. I'm going to cut the facing for the peplum and the blouse. Thanks for watching, guys. If I'm able to, I'll make a video of how to sew it. I'm not able to, I'll just take a picture of it and put the finished outfit. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for those who have subscribed, who are returning watching. Thanks for the new subscribers. If you haven't subscribed yet and you're watching, please like, share and subscribe and leave a positive comment. Thank you. Bye. This is the finished outfit of the peplum blouse with some collar and zip in the front I was making earlier on. And this is the trouser to go with it. You can see it's very pretty, very beautiful. You can try yours at home when you have the time. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe and comment. If you are new here, if you are returning, thanks for returning. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks, God bless. I'll see you in my next video. Thanks, bye.